What's up, guys? It's Corey here again, back at you on YouTube, doing a carpet stretching here today. It's another one of those that, from what I'm getting, it's a Texas thing. We have house layouts here that are difficult to stretch, and a buddy of mine in California goes, I thought I'd like to maybe move to Texas, but from looking at all the carpet out there, it's just way more difficult. And I think maybe he's right. I'm getting the best training in the world, if it means anything, but let me try to take you through the paces of when I got here to what we agreed on and what I'm going to actually do about it. So see if I can put all this back together here. I'm upstairs, and all of it takes place upstairs, luckily. And the carpet is legitimately wrinkled. It's taken about, I think, 7 years to get to this stage, and it's not bad. So here we go. Let's go to the top of the stairs here, which is basically right here. First wrinkle is right here. The layout, take a look here. Got a door and a hall there, a pool table. We got something that weighs a lot, entertainment center, gun rack, all kind of fancy stuff going on here. Got the room here. We got cutouts on this side right here. And again, the wrinkle there. Hallway here, closet there, doorway here. Wrinkles in this room, and this is the simplest one I've seen yet. So what I'm going to do, I'm not going to go this way with it, because we want to try to pull a little slack out of over there. So, but hang on, I'll show you something that we're not going to be addressing. A couple things that we're not going to be addressing. This guy, I don't think we're going to do anything about it at all. It's very small, right here. Maybe if when I'm done with all of that, we might do a little knee kick just for aesthetics to, you know, fix that. And we got some stuff over here that we're not going to be messing with either, because we're not going to be, there's this here and there's movement over there somewhere. And it's on a low humidity day right now, so you're not seeing everything that's here, you know, like you would if it was a high humidity day. So we're not moving any of this, and we're not going to address this. So the plan is to basically, I'm gonna cut right here, and we're gonna pull. I'm gonna stretch this guy first. We're gonna stretch it this way and pull some slack out of it. And then when I get to here, I'm gonna take it up as much as I can there, and we'll do that little trick you've seen me do before, where you pull it like crazy until you can almost. No guarantee, but you can almost get that wrinkle to go away. And it's beyond logic, but I've seen it happen, so I'm gonna give it a shot. So we're gonna pull this carpet here this way, cut that seam open, and we'll see how much I take out. Probably on average about there. So that will take care of enough to make the client happy. And when you have to explain all of this to people, you've kind of, you know, people don't understand how this works. So you've got to try to be consultative enough to explain how all of this works to people and point out, if I do this, you can expect this as a consequence to happen on the other side of the room. So to do this one, you've got to have a little experience. Well, a little more than a little experience to take on something like this. So I guess you would have to call this a good enough carpet stretch, because if I was to do it, you know, with the intention of actually stretching every inch of the carpet, it would involve a whole heck of a lot more than what I'm going to be doing here today. So what I'm going to do is go over here, and I'm probably going to cut the seam open first, and then I'm going to do all of my stretching. And this is probably going to be one of the ones that's difficult to stretch. I haven't seen the backing yet, but it probably will be difficult to stretch, because that's just my luck on a Saturday. This can come up here. We're going to go that way. So I'm going to shut up for a minute and get out some tools and reconvene the video as soon as I've got something taken care of here. I've got people texting me pictures of carpet that I've got to look at. I'm going to answer them back and make a video and stretch this carpet all at the same time. All right, so we're at now here. Got everything taken up everywhere, all through here. Got it cut, got this guy pulled up back to back to there, over here. This guy pulled up to the edge, into the edge, and it's taken up in here and in here, hoping that maybe I won't need to cut that. Who knows? We'll see. I might have to in order to get it to pull a little bit from right over there, but without taking it off here. So, yeah. Good times. Good times, good times. All right, I'll check back in here in a little bit. I'm not in any kind of hurry today. This is all I've got scheduled for the day, and it's cool outside. I'm not sweating my butt off like I usually am, so today's a good day. All right, a little update here where we're at now. Everything's stretched over here. Up to this point right here. A couple more stretches, and I'll be done with that. And then, I think, I'm gonna try something tricky over here that I haven't done before. It won't be in the video, but if it works, I'll tell you what I did. I'm gonna try something over here I haven't done before to aid in the removal of that guy there. There are several things you can do here, provided you can't make it stretch. What I've done in some videos is, if you just can't make this guy go away and you're wanting to just fix the aesthetics of it all, what you can do is you can cut it open and cut a small sliver out. And sometimes you can cut it open and not cut anything out and put tape all underneath it. And then with irons, set the irons on the top, weld it to the tape on the bottom. It'll be rigid and hard and flat, and it won't stick up anymore. So there's always another way to do things that you haven't heard about yet. And this is the channel where you find them all, because I wasn't trained classically by the carpet mafia, whoever these guys are that make all these carpet rules that I haven't found yet. I'm the type to get it done and let you know how I did it rather than me check with you, see if it's okay if I do it. That's just me. All right, anyway, not to that yet. Not yet. Finish up here with this guy first. I'm telling you, man, you've got to get a Triforce power stretcher. They're just fun. You know, if you're like me and you work all the time, you spend a little bit of money on tools, because if you buy a toy, you'll never get to use it. You know, if I bought a boat, it would rot. Power stretcher, you get used all the time, though. Busy, busy. All right, guys, still vlogging here. Let me show you. Got everything stretched over here. So now we're doing this. We're pulling that carpet this way and this carpet that way. And these guys have been placed one time and stretched. And I can already see this guy has went down over here. I'm thinking one more pull and I'll have this. It defies logic and reason as to why that would do that. It makes you think that you're pulling the carpet basically in just kind of a line right down the center without having to move all of the carpet. Maybe there's a carpet scientist out there who can explain why this happens. I don't know. But somebody somewhere tell me that I can't do this, and I'll stop. Somebody tell me somewhere you can't do that, Corey, and I'll quit right now. But you're not going to be able to tell me that before I'm finished, so keep watching. We are good. That is gone. Why do I feel like I owe somebody an apology in some other state that thought I couldn't do that? I don't know. I didn't know if I could either till I tried. Anyway, I'm gonna go over here and nail all this in place. cut my little piece out and seam it together, and we might be done here, or we might look at doing some other stuff. I'm thinking we're gonna quit with this right here. Anyway, I cut this guy off here and seam this together, but this is going a whole lot smoother than it could. Sure is. Almost got this guy seamed together here. I'm gonna let it cool a little bit. And actually, I'm gonna have to use the stretchers to pull this guy together. It somehow it slid apart a little bit. So I'm gonna have to take some of these nails out here and squeeze it together and put some nails back in it and then finish that guy up here. So we're close. All right, we are finishing up. Just like I said, had to pull some nails out of here. I could have pulled them all out at this point. It really didn't matter, but pull those out and was able to get those together right there. So I'm seaming the last little bit of it together from the top. And that leaves, got to do some tucking in here, over here, along here, and along here, and I'll be done. I cut everything off from here. So we're about that close to being done with the whole week. Pretty close. So when I get done with this, I'll try to update a couple more times, but we're almost done. All right, we are finally completely done here. I got everything put back in place, tucked in, cut off, seamed together. All of that is finally done here. So I'm gonna put away my tools and vacuum all this up, and I will be officially on my weekend here. So yeah, wrinkle gone, wrinkles gone, seam done, all done. One more week done here at Carpal Muscle TV. All right, guys, I appreciate you watching the video. As always, if you have questions, you're welcome to text. One other thing, it doesn't happen so much here, but we don't do debates on, you know, whether you seem left or right, top to bottom. We don't do that in the comment section. Debates like that are to be handled in some, you know, little crap Facebook room or something where guys like to get together and argue about carpet. You know, what this is about me helping people and people following. There's a correct way to address things. If you think, well, hey, you know, it'd actually be better if you did this, I can hear that. But a lot of the way things are worded are by guys that aren't good at talking, basically. Make better carpetmen than they do PR guys. So think about the way you address things, and appreciate you guys stopping by, and you know who you are. Anyway, God bless, guys. See you on the next video.